Hello, everybody. Today we have Mr. Aurya Agarwal amongst us. He is the founder and CEO of Flam. Hi, Aurya, and welcome to BW Business World.
Thanks, Urvi.
Great. So I hope you are having a good Monday and a pleasant morning. So with that high note, let's just start off with what does Flam do? What are its services like?
Sure. So Urvi, Flam is literally the world's very first augmented reality-based social network. Obviously, all of us who might be listening to this, all of us are on social networks, right? We are either on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook. Why exactly then we need another social network, which is supposedly on augmented reality, right? Because we believe that interfacing will change, and hence people in future will no longer interact on this 2D screen or this particular flat screen. We will wear glasses and see the world through a camera. That's exactly what we are building at Flam. So when we talk about augmented reality based social network, it's basically camera which is the centerpiece in the entire social network. That's what we are building at Flam.
Okay, so how will it benefit the user, given that augmented reality is something that we are not familiar with on a day-to-day basis?
Sure, Urvi. So this is in fact one of the very interesting questions that we have been able to answer with Flam. I think whenever you really want massive adoption of any new technology, it's a barrier for users, right? Like when our parents wanted to really use WhatsApp, it was a barrier. How do you send a message on WhatsApp was a barrier, right? It still is for a lot of people, right? So whenever there is a new technology that needs to be massively adopted, there is always a barrier on how users are going to get acquainted with the whole field. I think what we are really doing is we are making it easier for users. So for example, internet became massively adopted because social networks started to happen on internet, right? Because, I mean, we did not start to order food on internet first. We started to social network on internet, and then we basically understood how to use internet, and then we are doing every other thing on internet. Similarly, augmented reality is a future which is inevitable. Like every one of us, whether we believe it or not today, once we start wearing glasses, everything will be augmented reality. Like the way you do things today will shift to AR interfaces. And what we are really doing is making people aware of that and making people getting into that behavior of doing everything with augmented reality. And that's what Flam will help people do, because Flam is a social network, and social network is always a very strong initial point to adapt to any new technology. Like because people do want to social network. So when you provide that platform, users are generally happy to get into the new behavior always. So yeah.
When we talk about something like new behaviors, a lot of people are technology agnostic or technology averse outright. Given that WhatsApp has been something which we have gradually gotten acquainted to, especially people from the previous generation, how do you plan to convince the consumer to take on something entirely new?
Sure. So Urvi, that's the reason. So see, augmented reality based social network, we are talking about this, right? So like when I talk to you or when I talk to investors or when I talk to advisors, we're talking like this. But the moment we are back to users, we don't use any of these terms, like, right? Because users don't really care about whether you build it on AR, whether you build it on camera. They just don't care about it, right? What they really care about is, have their experiences become better because of the technology that you're using, right? So users always care about the product. And we have very, very, we have just simplified the product for them a lot. Like, let me explain the product to you, right? How we talk to users. So Urvi, have you printed a picture in your life? Like, I'm sure you have printed, right?
Yes, of course.
Of course, like people have been printing pictures for the last 200 years. So it's very, very easy for people to understand. Yes, I have printed a picture. And the moment they say yes, the next question is, have you ever imagined printing a video? And now people are like, okay, now this is what I really want to do. And the entire technology behind doing this is basically whole AR stuff and all those complex things. But for a user, what we have really launched as a first product is printed videos. So now users can print videos. When I say that you can print a video, it's essentially like a photograph which gets printed. And the moment you look at that photograph through our camera, you can see the video playing inside that picture itself. So that's how simplified it is for users so that they can use. I mean, my parents have used our app very easily. Like they did not even call and ask me. So I was super impressed, because even for using Facebook or WhatsApp, they used to call me like 3 times a day. So I think, yeah, that's very important.
Okay, that's a really interesting technology. We have seen it in TV and movies about moving pictures on walls and
Yeah,
similar
in
stuff.
fact, you are in fact pretty much on point over there for a lot of Gen Z audiences and for a lot of millennials. This analogy is even more simplified version that have you seen Harry Potter moving images? And then people are like, yes, and that's exactly the product. So it becomes very easy to relate what exactly we are building.
Yes, so that is exactly the movie that came to my mind as soon as you said moving images. So yes, for the Harry Potter generation, I think it's a little easier to visualize now than anybody else. So moving ahead with the discussion, given that you already have some tangible technology at hand, what are your business plans to expand your company like?
Sure. So Uri, when you ask about the business plan, is it really the monetizing strategy?
Partly the monetizing, partly you can tell us about which cities, or is your audience limited to tier one and tier two cities, or are you planning on international expansion?
Sure, Urvi. So let me quickly cover both the points. I think the first one, which is like expansion, is really important. So we are right now not at all focusing on monetizing the product. Obviously, like the list price is there, you can buy our flam cards, but we are really not optimizing too much on revenues because that's anyways not the goal. The goal here is that can we get users used to this new behavior of interacting with friends through augmented reality interfaces? That's the whole purpose and optimization. So right now, monetizing wise, we are not at all optimizing on revenue. So that's out of the picture right now. But yes, we are internationalizing. So next month, we are launching in the US, next month or maybe end of next month, something like that. And also, we are expanding into a lot of more product features. So like, for example, just for an idea, I'm 100% sure you have used either WhatsApp status or Instagram stories. So we are launching a feature called Stories, where you can basically change videos on the same flam card. So basically, it's a printed picture, and you can keep on changing the video on the same card. So more product features will be launched in the coming months. And yes, geographically, US is a very serious market for us, so we will be expanding over there. India, we have almost 600 plus cities where users have been using our product already. So yes, I mean, that's the gist.
Okay, so since we are talking about business plans, what are your goals for 2021-22, given in terms of market size and user base? And what is your user base right now? Can you give us some numbers?
Sure. So, Urvi, I think what will really help is I will quickly show you the product because it's a very, very unusual product to imagine. So I will help you understand the product first, and then all those metrics that we are really looking at will start to make much more sense. So like, give me just like 5 seconds. So when we say that we are building an AR-based social network, camera is the centerpiece. So when I say camera is the centerpiece, you create content and you consume content through camera. That's the whole idea. Okay. Like, for example, right now, if you talk about Instagram, Snapchat, any of these social networks, content consumption is not happening through camera. Content creation is happening through camera. But like, whenever you consume content, you're consuming content on this particular 5-inch screen, right? You're just scrolling and consuming content, whether it's video, audio, picture, you just do that, right? The whole idea about AR social network is camera should do both the things. So in our particular case, this is the product which is right now, users are using this product right now, which is flam card. This is a video. Okay. The moment I place my camera on this, once again, I think the video plays on the picture itself, and I don't know if this is visible to you, but like this is basically, yeah. So this is basically content consumption happening through camera because it's not your phone feed. It's the video playing on the real world in the real picture, right? So that's the whole content consumption through camera, what we really mean to say. So you are interacting with reality through your camera and the video is playing. This is the product. Now, when I talk about this product, what becomes really important for us when we look at metrics is that how frequently are users doing this? Like, because that's what will build the whole habit, right? When you're really scrolling and consuming content, we were not doing this 5 years back. But today we are heavily doing that, right? Because the user habit has formed over time. So what we really are interested in, how many people are consuming content through our camera on these flam cards, right? That's exactly what we really care about. So this is basically called as interactions. Whenever we say that we have added one more interaction, it means that one more user has basically opened our camera and consumed content on the Flam cards. That's what we really mean. So this number is something which is really important for us. And in the last 4 months, this number has been really growing very fast. In fact, in the last 4 months, I think we have crossed 85 million such interactions, which is a really large number. Also puts us in the top 5 consumer AR apps in the world. Obviously, like Snapchat is in the first spot, and this is like Snapchat has like crazy numbers and much ahead of us. But I think it's a really good start for an early stage company like us. So going forward, this is the number what we really want to increase. Like these are say 85 million interactions today. We want to like touch 1 billion interactions in say 12 to 18 months from now. So yeah, that's what is really important.
One thing about technology is that as soon as it becomes popular, be it say a chatting platform or like we see the edtech boom right now, it has grown popular and many people are coming on board. Similarly, when we talk about the AR technology you are using, if you look at the trends, we might have other companies in the future duplicating your business models or adding their own flavor to it. How will you stay relevant as a first timer in the field of technology, which can be advanced much ahead?
Sure. So Urvi, this is always interesting to answer such questions. But I think first things first, this is hard technology. This is like talking about Apple. So Apple looks pretty much simple on the outside when we look at it from the user's perspective. But it's like complex technology, right? They work a lot on technology research, and I mean R&D is one of their largest departments as far as I know. So this is exactly the case with Flam as well. On the outside, it looks like okay, a video played on the Flam card, right? But it takes a lot of interesting tech to make this happen seamlessly. So I think tech will definitely be a barrier over here. It's not like another edtech or fintech company where you just copy the business model and it's done. You really need some serious brains to actually work on the tech side and make it possible for the users. Secondly, obviously, when it comes to companies like Instagram or even like Snapchat, they are continuously innovating. So if you look at it, how Snapchat's journey has been, we will also have to continuously innovate in terms of new products, new features. So those things are there. And I think the most important thing is in our particular case, Flamcards is something which is a hardware. It's like a physical entity, right? So when I talk about Flamcards, it's like they create a barrier in themselves. So for example, if we happen to distribute like 100 million Flamcards in next 2 years, those 100 million Flamcards, even if someone creates the exact same technology, exact same product, those 100 million Flamcards will only play if someone actually has the Flam camera. So that's a very, very high quality barrier that we're creating. It's like AI. So if you want to create Google today, you can, because everyone knows how Google code has been written now, right? Because you know, in like 15 years, people get to know. But if you start building Google today, you still cannot, even if you write better code than Google, because they have so much learning in last 15 years. So I think data and Flam cards will play a very high quality barrier role in our case as well.
Yes, no, experience is like hands-on experience, which is true, like you said, in Google, and I'm sure in Flam Pay also. So one thing I wanted to ask you, like you were talking about Flam cards. So that is one of your key products, I'm guessing. In addition to that, do you have any other key products in your portfolio, and what are the other technologies the company is working on?
So, Urvi, I think product-wise, we have a lot of upcoming features. Like I talked about stories. So like you can, I mean, as I played one single video on this card, you can play or change videos on the same card. So for example, today, if me and my friend, we are talking to each other on Snapchat today, tomorrow we can talk to each other through Flam cards. Because if I have my friend's Flam card, she has my Flam card, we can literally talk through images, right? So talking pictures, basically, I can change content on her card, she can do it on my card. And there are multiple such features which are in the pipeline. But when it comes to technology, yes, I mean, we are working on some really interesting tech even today. Like we are working on cloud infra for AR, we are working on some extended reality. So extended reality is, I'll just quickly explain you how extended reality functions. So, you know, again, some context before we get into that. So, for example, when we say that, Urvi, we are changing the way people consume content. So right now, people are consuming content on this particular screen. because of FLAM, people will consume content through camera. That's what we are doing, right? But when we say that we are changing the way people consume content, what's really happening is we are changing the content people consume. So for example, if my girlfriend sends me a flying kiss, on this particular screen, it can maximum be a video, right? Because that's exactly what the screen can do. But if it's a FLAM card, hearts will really come out of the card when she really does that, because I have the leverage of this whole space, right, between my phone and the FLAM card. And I can take those hearts outside the FLAM card. This is extended reality. I can put those hearts wherever I want in my room. And next time when I enter the room, I can open my camera and I can see how my room looks like with different things that I've placed inside. So now these are very, very complex technologies. Like honestly, I think, and in fact, the good news is that we have a lot of mentors who have worked on products like Google Maps. In fact, one of the person is co-founder of Google Maps and someone who has created the data science team of Orchard. So these people are literally going to be very helpful in this whole journey. But I think, yes, a lot of work has to be done. So, yeah.
Okay, that's quite interesting to hear about these new technologies that maybe we didn't even imagine, or we saw only on, as we discussed earlier, on television only.
Yeah.
So can you tell me about what, according to you, is the future of augmented reality or extended reality in India, be it from a business perspective or otherwise from technology?
Sure. In fact, not just India, from the global perspective, because whenever such changes or such behavioral changes happen, they cannot be restricted to one country or a limited geography, because I mean, these changes are massive changes. They cannot happen just because India wants to do it, right? They will always happen on a global level. So Urvi, like, smartphone revolution happened, right? Like when smartphones happened, the whole interfacing changed, right? Like honestly, it's very, very interesting to understand that everything that has happened on internet has happened in last 10 years. Like 2008 or 9 is when Play Store was launched. And now we have seen like millions of apps on Play Store, right? It's like that quick. So the whole idea is that when hardwares change, interfacing changes. Like for example, today we are on this smartphone hardware. So this is the screen on which we are doing everything, right? From social networking to ordering food, groceries, booking a cab, everything is happening on this particular screen because this is the hardware that we've been given, right? 2 years from now, in fact, not even 2 years, it can be faster than that. But like 2 years from now, this will change. We will no longer have smartphones with us. We will start to wear glasses. And that's the whole hardware change that will happen, right? Once we are on glasses, everything will be augmented reality. So glasses by default means that you are wearing a camera all the time, right? Because that's the lens that you're wearing all the time. Now, the moment you have glasses, the interfacing will change from this 2D screen. See, this is what technology does to Siri talking to me. So, anyways, so when this happens, everything will be AR. So what we believe is that every company by default is going to be an AR company. Whether you want it or not, like today, whether you want it or not, you are an internet company, you are an application-based company. If you want to build a really large business, 2 years from now, every company by default will be an AR company. If you're building an e-commerce business, you have to have e-commerce on AR. Like Flipkart is doing it already. Like everybody is getting into this space in bits and pieces. Alibaba is doing it. Amazon is doing it. If you really want to build a furniture business, you have to build an AR furniture. EdTech will be AR. FinTech will be AR. But all of this will happen once people get into the habit of doing all of these AR related things. And I think social network has to be the starting. That's why we are building FLAM.
Technology and social network are completely unavoidable these days.
Especially. Exactly. Like internet has been massively adopted because people were crazy about using Facebook. They were never crazy about using Swiggy or Zomato. Swiggy, Zomato will happen. I mean, they are such fundamental human needs that if you build Swiggy, Zomato on top of internet, they will happen. But they cannot be the starting point. Like 10 years back, if you were told or if your parents were told that, hey, you can order food through Swiggy, they would say, no, I can call the restaurant, no, and they will deliver the food whatever I want. But people cannot resist not using Facebook or WhatsApp because they are social networking fundamental human needs, which you will do. So they will learn internet just because they want to be with friends on Facebook and WhatsApp. That's exactly what will happen with AR. So AR will inevitably become big. It's just that e-commerce cannot make it big. Like, you don't want to like shop wearing glasses. You don't really want to do that. But if you really can interact with your friends with a much interesting experience, you will do that.
Sorry, one interesting question that comes to my mind is related to cybersecurity. When we talk about Zomato, Swiggy, and all the parallel platforms that have come up, data leak is emerging as one of the major challenges that they face. Having said that, do you foresee similar challenges in augmented reality with respect to consumer data? And if yes, how do you plan to counter it?
This is one of the very interesting questions, Ruby, again, because I mean, and in fact, this is privacy will be a major question when it comes to metaverse, which is now a pretty much used word because Mark Zuckerberg talked about it. So whenever we talk about metaverse, it cannot be massively adopted if privacy is not taken care of, because this is still, you know, what's the difference? Like, when we talk about the current social networks, that's like very, very controlled because you are on your phones. What you really do is what they really know, right? But the moment you are on AR interfaces, everything can be tracked. Like, ideally, everything can be tracked, right? So you're right, like, privacy will become a major concern. Like, we are pretty much taking care of that, at least with Flam cards. And even going forward, because we believe that Web 3.0, whosoever will win the whole social network game, will have to take care of user privacy, because now users know that user privacy is a major, major thing to be worried about. So yeah, I mean, we are taking care of that. And I think everybody will have to, otherwise they cannot create a social network or anything for that matter on AR.
So we have a long way to go legislatively as well as technologically as far as cybersecurity is concerned. So hopefully that will be catered to soon enough. So before we wind up for the day, I wanted to ask you one more question. How do we get hold of Flam cards? Do we send you certain videos, or are they pre-made, or are they delivered at home? How is the user supposed to get hold of them?
Sure, Urvi. It's a very simple user journey. Honestly, like you or any other user uses Instagram, like, we upload videos and we just post them on Instagram. Similarly, over here, you open up Flam app website, you just upload your video, whatever you want to really print as a Flam card. You just upload your video. You can drag and select which frame of the video you really want to print as a Flam card, or you can select a different picture altogether. Okay, it's like thumbnails on YouTube. You can select what thumbnail you really address you really want us to deliver. We would deliver to that particular address. Once you get your Flam card, there is a very small instruction manual that we deliver along the Flam card, which says, hey, unveil your video, surprise video inside the card through this app, and then you can just experience the Flam card. You can order it for yourself, you can order it for your friends, and yes, have fun.
Okay, thank you so much, Shaurya, for telling us about this new technology. I'm sure a lot of people would know, including me, that there are such possibilities. So with that note, I'll take your leave for the day. Thank you so much for joining us.
Sure. Thanks, Urvi. And irrespective of this interview, just use Flam cards. You will really get some idea on how the future will look like, and more importantly, what augmented reality really is. So you should definitely use the product.
If you really I'll have a look at that. It sounds pretty interesting. So thank you, and take care.
Thanks, Urvi. Thanks for your time. Bye.